Hello and welcome to the 30-second video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can prepare for a new project and set up a new document in After Effects. In the last video, I demonstrated the plan and design process I go through when I start a video presentation. Now, once I have spent time planning and designing my video presentation, I will then start to bring it all to life in After Effects. In this video, we are going to start by reviewing the things we will need to keep in mind before and after we begin an After Effects project. So in this video, we will be covering the following topics: making a project folder and setting up a new After Effects document. After this video, we will be ready to proceed and start building our video presentation. So before we jump into After Effects, I want to quickly talk about preparation. In my experience, I have created lots of small projects in After Effects, and it's always helped me to be organized. When working with a project in After Effects, it's as important to be organized out of After Effects as it is in After Effects. A typical After Effects project will include a wide variety of media, so it helps to be organized with the media before you bring it into After Effects. To solve this, I always start with a project folder. This is where I organize and keep all my media elements before I place them into After Effects. This way, I know exactly where everything is, so it's not scattered about on my computer. So, let's get into it. So here is my project folder, and as you start to use After Effects, I recommend you have something similar. This is a blank template, and every time I start a new After Effects project, I will duplicate this to have a fresh copy for a new project. So let's take a look at this. So with the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder into folder 32, Preparation, and open the blank project folder, and you will see my blank project template folder. So this folder contains four main folders: one, Plan and Design; two, Work; three, Assets; and four, Exports. So all my plan and design files will go into the first folder. This will be all the documents we may create before we start in After Effects, as featured in the previous episode. Now, as we work in After Effects, we will save our documents into the Work folder, as there are often various versions. All media we use for the project will go into the Assets folder, and later, when we export, we will place the exported video into the Exports folder. So, in the Plan and Design folder, I have a number of folders. We have a folder for the planning. This could be where I keep a brief and my planning sheets. I have a folder where I keep my storyboard sketches, and a folder where I will keep my design files such as my Photoshop documents. In the Assets folder, I have a number of folders separating the media types. Here we have audio, images, typefaces, and video. And into these, I will place the specific types of media. In the Image folder, again, I have a number of folders, though this time separating out the specific media types. Here I have AI for Illustrator vector documents, a JPEG folder for flat images, a PNG folder for images with alpha channels, and a PS folder for Photoshop compositions and graphics. So before starting a project, if I have any media to start, I will place them all into these appropriate folders. So this is a blank template I will always start a new project with. What I'm going to do now is copy and paste my template folder onto the desktop, so I have a brand new folder ready for my project and I know where it is. And I'll rename this folder to London Top 5. Now, you can either copy my folder structure, make your own, or simply copy and paste my template folder. Whatever you do, make sure you know where your project folder is for later. Okay, so once we have the project folder ready, it's time to set up the document in After Effects. So I'll open up After Effects and begin by coming up to File, New, and click New Project. Upon click, we will be presented with a blank interface ready to start. Now the first thing I always do when I start a fresh new project is set up my folder structure over in the Project panel. So the idea here is to try and match the folder structure in the Project folder, again so we know where everything is. So I'll begin by clicking the New Folder button at the bottom of the Project panel, and I'll name this to Assets. With the folder selected, I'll click back on the New Folder button at the bottom of the project panel, and I'll name this folder Images. With the folder selected, I'll click back on the New Folder button at the bottom of the project panel, and I'll name this folder JPEG. This time, I'll click back on the Images folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder PNG. I'll click back on the Images folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder Vectors. Again, I'll click back on the Images folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder PS Comps. So next, I'll click back on the Assets folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder Video. Again, I'll click back on the Assets folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder Audio. So to finish off, I'll click off the Assets folder and add a new folder, and I'll name this folder Comps. With the folder selected, I'll add a new folder and I'll name this folder Pre-Comps. So when naming this folder, I'll make sure I place a hyphen at the start, as this ensures the folder will always stay at the top as I add more content into this folder. So I'll select the Comps and the Pre-Comps folder, click on the colored square and change the color to red. On this occasion, I'll click and drag the color box column header and carefully drag before the folder names like so. Next, I'll select all the Assets folders and set these to a yellow color. So now we have a nice, neat folder structure ready to manage media contents. This is going to make everything super organized and make our workflow in After Effects much easier. So one last thing I'm going to do here is come up to File and scroll down to Project Settings. Now upon click, a menu box will open. So here I'll come and click the second tab from the left, Time Display Style. Now for this, I'm going to make sure that for time code, footage start time is set to 0. So I'll click on the dropdown and make sure time code is set to 0. With this set, I'll click OK. So now, come up to File and click Save. Navigate to your project folder, click into the Work folder, and in here, save the new document. Name it London Top 5 and click Save. So now, we have a new project ready to start the video presentation. In the next video, we are going to start with the first section of the video presentation. We are going to look at how to create the first section and animate type and graphic elements. So see you in the next video.